What's going on, guys? MediSquid here, and we are back with episode number 7. If you missed episode 6, you can go back and check it on the playlist and the channel that I have set up. More or less, we just made our way through the swamp. As you maybe look at the camera when we're doing this thing. Made our way through the swamp, got into what I consider to be the coolest town I've ever seen in a Pokemon game that includes fan-made games so far, like, overall. And then we went to Mesto Mountain. That was Excello Village, by the way. Went to Mesto Mountain, and Mesto Mountain's really cool, too. I did swap some team members around. So, Nidoran evolved. Nidoran's now Nidorino. I caught a Rhyhorn. I'm raising Rhyhorn with the experience share. I got Shroomish up to level 15, and so basically, Nidorino, Staryu, Shroomish, and Pidgey are... I also caught a Murkrow, but I wasn't too sure if I wanted to use Murkrow or not. I ended up... The Lotad that I did catch in the last episode just had a terrible nature. Like, it lowered, I think it lowered either defense or special defense. I don't know. Basically, I want Lotad to be kind of like a wall, almost, when I evolve it into Ludicolo, because it also has Rain Dish. What was Rain Dish? Yeah, there it is. And then I ended up getting one that had Modest, so I'll be able to do a lot with this Lotad. Shroomish is going to evolve at level 22. I don't know when Rhyhorn evolves into Rhydon, but I figured Rhydon would be a good solution to any electric types I find. These statues fascinating. I think this Green Mountain was completely barren for a millennia, all because of the Green Guardian. All because this Green Guardian didn't approve of the wars between humans. So, alrighty. Aha! I spot a clever, knowledgeable one. Come see me if you can answer my question correctly. If you do, you win a prize. Will you try to answer my riddles? Yes. Yes, good. My question is in time. What do we call a legend who watches over Mesto Mountain? It's the Green Guardian. Aha, that is completely correct. Congratulations, here's the final word. You're seeing an air balloon. But the mountain is tough, you should take this. Oh, thank you. This is a very traditional festival. We share traditional food. A century ago, people who fled the king's forces came to this mountain. They had to learn how to cook food from what little ingredients they could. Little ingredients they can find. Why don't you try out an old recipe we created? Stone macarons. It's only 200 Poke Dollars. Sure. Mesto macaron. They traditionally kept their Pokemon outside of its Pokeball at the festivals, but you still need quality Pokeballs to let them rest until they get hurt or tired. We took inspiration from the wild Pokemon like the highest result. These exclusive capture devices we call friend balls. My Pokemon are happy in the basic balls. I just remembered there is a some stuff over here. Green Guardian is a Pokemon. I wonder what would happen if somebody were to capture it. Says I can't go into the ruins and climb the mountain yet, but one day I'll show the guardian of the mountain. I'll show how close me and my Pokemon are. Once I get a Pokemon of my own, of course I mean. It's boring without marshmallows. Among all the festivities, let's not forget what we are celebrating. The Green Knight is said to be buried atop of the mountain. His brave spirit watches over us all, that's what I believe. Green Guardian, oh, I need to talk to this kid. Whoops. You know, I just realized Nidorino is the first evolution of the series. So that's pretty neat. this guy. Look at the mill tank cross the road. Hmm. Oh god, I'm starting to have PTSD flashbacks from the last Goldeen we fought. Oh wait, I have grass types now, what am I doing? I'll switch to his head. Why is Goldeen so bulky? Jeez. We have to switch to something else now. Let's see how much this does. I didn't notice, but I had a Mystic Water, so Staryu's holding the Mystic Water now. Oh wait, why did I do that? I don't know any of you guys who did a lot of competitive battling in Gen 6, but part of the reason why I like Breloom so much is because I have a substitute Focus Punch, Leech Seed. Yeah, substitute Focus Punch, Leech Seed, and I forget what the other attack was. Mach Punch. And that Pokemon was a team killer, like, assuming I set up right, which, I mean, it was pretty hard not to set up right, but if I got a chance to set up with that thing, like, I would just, people would hate me. So much. Oh! He's telling a story of Messed Up Mountain. This is so interesting to me. I think I'll still hear Robert. You can go ahead. This person seems to be too wrapped up in the story to notice you. Wrapped up in the story. Okay, apparently I'm just chopped liver. Lady up ahead, she would not stop talking, so I'm going back down the mountain. There'd be an item there. That must be the old lady that would not stop talking. Wow, this mountain is just magnifique. Probably just butchered that. Whoever was supposed to be French. Tourist Cherise. Cherise? I don't know. Beautifly. You're a Pidgey. Boop. Mime has better gust than my Digi does. Brave trainer wishing to challenge the mountain. You tell me, what's your name? Ah, Robert, a wonderful name. There are legends that names tell a much better person. Though sometimes I wonder whether it's the name that shapes us. Or us who shapes the name. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you for indulging an old woman in her ramblings. The most exciting part of the festival is the race up the mountain. At least for the energetic budding trainers like yourself, legends tell us of a certain knight during the War of Hawthorne. They were one of the anointed sovereign's trusted commanders. They hurried up the dangerous barren mountain together with their trusted partner, Pokemon. They wished to find the old guardian of the mountain. They wanted to do anything they could in order to rekindle the warmth in its frozen heart. Only that could save the people from starvation that they were besieged by the king's forces. Crude mesto macaroons could only fill their stomachs up for so long. The knight succeeded and was dubbed the Green Knight of the Mesto Mountain once again became. Once the Mesto Mountain once again became verdant with life. To honor his memory and prove their own worth to the guardians, trainers follow the knight's footsteps up the cliff and slopes. They seek the fabled temple of hopes and find the reward for the guardian himself. Take on the challenge if you wish, but stay vigilant. Every trainer who spots you will want to battle. Oh, there's one more thing. Green Knight kept his beloved Pokemon by his side at all times, and as such, the trainers ahead keep their Pokemon at their side, too. Maybe this will be a good time to let one of your own trusted partners out. It's your choice. Nidorino, you're with me all the way. Rising Star Jade would like to battle. Ugh. Psychic type. I guess Staryu. Maybe that Murkrow wouldn't be a bad idea. Maybe just keeping gas in the team wouldn't have been a bad idea. Send out something that I can handle, dude. Oh my gosh. Another psychic type. You know what? He's psychic flying. It's Rhyhorn's time. Rhyhorn's time to tap. Time to shine. Ugh. First. Ooh. Yeah, one thing I've learned about this game is you're not necessarily safe. Like, this game is kind of challenging, which I like. Although for some reason normal is hard, like hard mode. I'm not sure if that was on purpose or not, but I like it. Ooh, what? I think they put the, may or may not have put the animation on the wrong end of the screen there. It's a good thing I'm carrying a team of six then. Oh crap, I wasn't looking. Wasn't paying attention. Guess, hopefully it's not a psychic type or a ground type. Grubbin' no mud slap. Pokemon, let's battle first. Nurse Madeline would like to battle. You know, I'm actually gonna switch to Shroomish.
Thank you.
I messed up. Let me heal your Pokemon for you. You're done for, pal. I think you're a little confused there, my friend. You got a stick in your hair. This looks like a job for Lotad. Here we go! Another one of this BS. I mean, I have chest of berries, but... that effect spore really works, jeez. See how effective Shroomish is at his job. How many chest of berries do I have? I have two. Huff, I really regret riding a bike all the way up here. See, how did I know that? I just kind of guessed. It's like, you look like a item. Revive. I like that music. Come on, Ranger Vera. Ha! Doom. For a second there, I didn't see the frame where it did any damage to me. Stop growling, you big wimp. Fomantis. It's a bug grass type? Oh, I totally wasn't even thinking there. the design of the nurses in this game. Rising Star Finn. You know, let's let Ryan Horn have some fun. Tail flipping. Did you guys see? We had two different animations there. This is actually starting to look a little bit like my Gen 1 team. As far as like the Pokemon options go. Oh my god. I found there was a link, at least, between like me having a lot of battles and just not, like, the game just starts lagging and losing frames for some reason. I don't know why. I'm gonna have to reset the game, but I was looking at the timer and we're at just about a half hour, so that's gonna be it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys like this episode, make sure you comment down below, let me know how much you liked it, thumbs up the video, if that, you know, feeling generous today, or if you're not feeling generous, you should just do it anyway, because it does help out me and every other person on YouTube. I know we preach it so much, and you know, you just kind of think, like, oh, they're asking me for it, I'm not gonna do it. Well, you should. You just should. Anyways, guys, yeah, that's going to be the video. Thank you so much for watching. As per the usual, guys, have yourselves a great day. Great day. Why am I thumbs down in great day? It should be thumbs up great day. Yeah, that's going to be it, guys.